What's good, guys? We are gonna play some Yu-Yu today. I never played Yu-Yu this gen, I think only 3 games and for fun. Before we start, big shoutouts to user ADF Test, who passed me this team. Actually, she didn't. I got this team from BTB Bear of the Best. Shoutouts to you too. And I wanna say sorry to user ADF Test too, because I have said some things that I shouldn't have said. It was just for fun. It was just like a joke thing between friends, is what I thought, but I guess it was too much what I did. But yeah, we're not gonna talk about that. You know what I mean. If you hear this, I hope you hear this. I don't even know if you still watch my videos. But yeah, we will go over the team. We have a Nidoqueen with offensive Nidoqueen with rocks, which is interesting, and AV Bishop. I have no idea what these things do in Yu-Yu, right? Because I don't even know what's in Yu-Yu. I just know that a lot of things that were in OU last gen. So we have double assault vest mons. I think I know Ladi is in UU, Ladi has, so that's why we have a bishop probably. And AV Serena is probably a check Kaldu, as we see he's a specs Kaldu on our own team. Which actually I'm pretty hyped to use Kaldu. It's still my channel mascot, I have to update my channel mascot to a Sun Moon mon, but I still like Kaldu. We have a Scarf Gengar, which is actually like the only set you see most of the times in OU. We have a like mixed defensive Klefki with more fist stuff, with spikes, T-Wave, Foul Play, and Toxic. I have like no idea what's coming in UU. I know Clefable came down here, and this team is like not at the. This team is not new, this team is a few weeks old, I think. So I think the tier changes were afterwards, so it might be weak to some things that came down or came up from lower tiers, is what I meant to say. And yeah, I don't have any points since I like already said I didn't play much UU this gen, and this the points already got deleted that I got. Like I only was at 1200 maybe, and they got deleted because Bank came out. So Spike Skelly looks like a actually not a good lead because he has the two birds here that are probably probably Mega Aerodactyl or Mega Smacker should beat on UU. Yeah, Smacker should be right. So it's either Rox Aerodactyl or Rox this. I don't know why he has both birds. Usually one is enough. So what even leads off with these birds? I feel like Klefki leads off with them pretty fine. Unless it's Earthquake. So you cannot T-Wave Prankster Dark Times, but you can T-Wave this thing. So yeah, we will just click that yellow magic turn 1. Because we are scum and we hit, which is nice. We get a full para. That's how Thunderwave should work, and we will just start getting up spikes, get up these layers, so Kaldu can start dealing damage. I mean, a nice para. I mean, Jessica doesn't care about spikes, but I will just throw off a foul play as this guy said bullshit. Oh, he reveals Earthquake, that does a shit ton, I guess. That's why he got mad. We don't have Levitate and Gengar, and this doesn't have, what's this thing called? Magnet Rise. So what do we even do here? Serena aim not speed, 243. Serena should outspeed him, right? So we go hard Serena. Not sure if Serena can even kill this. Why is this team so weak to Earthquakes? I mean, let's just go with Serena here and we will see. I mean, this is max attack, so. High Jump Kick probably doesn't even kill. Actually, it's at 53. High Jump Kick should kill, right? Yeah, okay, few. I didn't want to make a calc there. It's like 3 AM here and I'm really tired. But yeah, I wanted to get this video done because I want to bring you guys some more, some different tiers and some different content. And I also want to say sorry to you, the ADF, like I already did, but yeah. I was actually like planning to do some like video, some joke video, but I'm actually not gonna do that. Cause that wouldn't be right. And I feel really bad for that idea. I mean, a video would have been funny, but it wouldn't, like, it just wouldn't be right to do that. I don't wanna talk about that. He's probably gonna pursue me here, but Kaldu is just a play. So he doesn't pursue me, he's just two joins. So just bullet punches, I don't get that play. This is a free hydro pump, I think. I mean, it's a free scald, but. Yeah, it's a free Scald. Let's not worry about the Cresselia. Yeah, Scald kills the Scizor. No reason to risk a miss. I don't know why he stayed in, but okay, when he had a Cress. So yeah, I can just go bishop on the threat. Bishop or Gengar. Bishop should be fine. As he goes for psychic, and do I pursue this? I don't see a reason not to go for knockoff, so I will just click knockoff. Yeah, he goes for common. This should 2-hit KO easily. Yeah, we'll just knock off. Okay, just forfeits. So we get 50 points for that. We get our first win. Let's just move on to the next one. It is actually nice that I'm gonna get some points. This guy has a talent from a Puko Magoo, which is pretty interesting, because shoutouts to Advanship, who actually uses like SD Supersonic Sky Strike Talent Flame. I think he even uses it in OU. Let me say, have fun. Talonflame only has Gale Wings if it's at 100%, so. And Serena cannot be brave, but yeah, Serena is not a counter to Talonflame, but just in general, Queenly Majesty prevents me from getting hit by priority. Why did he say I hope the same for you? What the fuck? That sounds weird. I feel like Nidoqueen is an okay lead here, as we get that wrong. I don't really have good switch-ins to this. Like, what is Serena even doing back? Like, what? I didn't even think about this thing being a threat. Nidoking is nice for the Rotom. Yeah, I don't really know what my play is. Where is this thing? If he goes for Aqua Ring, so he's some defensive set. I'm not too worried about that. Just gonna drop kick this. Okay, that did nothing. But we get an attack drop, so we don't get 2-hit KO'd, but he gets an attack drop on his own. So let's U-turn out into Klefki now that we have the attack drop. Is she Kelly or Klefki? Klefki should be fine. But yeah, you guys already know, or already realize, I don't know too much what these mons do. I mean, yeah, I know what Aggronaut does, but this is some weird leftover set. I'm just gonna toxic this, because this thing's really annoying. Yeah, that seems like the play to make for sure. So yeah, I don't have anything in call that who knows what's going on in UU. But yeah, since this is a low ladder, I should be able to handle this, right? So we hit, he's immune, because yeah, never mind, he's immune, because Prankster doesn't affect, as it says here in Gen 7 Dark is immune to Prankster. In case anyone would be confused, it says that. So this is actually a huge threat. I don't have Play Rough, which sucks. I kind of want to go hard into Gengar here, but it's risky. But yeah, I feel like going hard Gengar is the play I have to make, as we get predicted. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I disabled this Naga, but maybe I should have just gone up Spike. I mean, he doesn't have hazard control, so rocks are really nice. I'm gonna hit my rocks up here. He has parting shot, okay. Parting shot is interesting. It was like only a few mons got it last gen, and now like a lot of more mons get it. And I think this guy's like defensive. I mean, I would speed this anyway since I'm offensive Nidoqueen. Sludge Wave should 2-hit KO if it doesn't kill. Yeah, it killed. Okay, that crit might not. I'm not sure. But I think this is. That means level up Shiva's Nidoqueen. Oh, we had a minus one. Yeah, that crit definitely mattered. I didn't see that we were at minus one. You guys can actually, like, probably realize I'm not playing up. I mean, maybe I'm playing okay, but I could play a bit better. The Gengar Sake wasn't necessary. But we'll just go Klefki on this. I mean, Klefki doesn't even do much to this. The only thing I need Klefki for, I'm gonna just get out of a spike. The only thing I need Klefki for is for Puko Magoo to toxic it. I can just keep Serena around, and I can just get up full layers of spikes. So Puko Magoo takes all the damage. I think that's okay. Foul playing maybe would have been decent, but the Photon Switch is foul play. I mean, I can just go Kelly and click Secret Sword. He doesn't have good switch-ins. I think Jimiko, how it's called, resists, but yeah, it takes a lot from Secret Sword. I just saw we have Focus Blast. Specs Focus Blast is like strong as fuck, but you have to hit. So yeah, I will try to get like people in call who know much more, like know more about you as we move on. If I do more lives, I feel like Nidoqueen is the play here. No one overheats. Oh, he will always, that's fine. Like, I can just fire off Sludge Waves. Like, he doesn't have good switch-ins to that at all. So he's defensive for him. Why did he make that play if he was defensive for him? Talonflame should die. He doesn't even have all HP, yeah. Offensive Sneaker King coming through. I don't know what Chimiko does. I feel like Heart Bishop is fine. Still want to keep this for, so he cannot Volt Switch. I mean, it's Curse. Maybe it's Max Bedef or some shit. I'll just knock this off then for big damage. Oh god, that did a shit ton. Now considering this is AV and not Dreadblade. So yeah, all these hazards are too much for this guy. Pikumuku gonna take 10 million. I don't care if it's a momentum, I'm just gonna knock this off. It is helmet, okay. And he goes for counter. I mean, I guess it's nice for him that he gets a kill. Let me finish this game off with 3, not a stick. What the fuck? Just dropkick this, and I should have speed the Rotom since I'm offensive Serena. How much speed does the Serena run again? Oh yeah, the guy already forfeited, I think. So yeah, let me grab another one. I think Clefable is down here, if I didn't already mention it, that's disgusting to think about this. Clefable is down here. There's also Alakazam. Volcanion, if it's still UU. Oh, that's Primarina. I want to use Specs Primarina and UU so badly. I think it's cool in OU, but it's not the best. And in UU, I think it has more potential. I think there's Suicune, which moved up from RU. I'm not sure if it did. I think it did. This guy has some heat. Good fucking god. I feel like I'm gonna get blown away by this double Shell Smash Core and the Chris Snorlax and the SD Dublade. What does he have set up on everything? What if this is comment? All these threats, dude. I mean, Kelly just spams Hydro Pump this game. I just need the Snorlax a bit weakened. I guess this is the resist to pump too. So he might lead with Cloyster or... Let me just think this through before I make like a rush play. I think Kelly is a decent lead or Klefki. Yeah, I feel like Kelly is overall the best. I'm gonna just scald this. Hope for a burn. Don't get a burn. I should live any one hit right. Scarf Ganger does not outspeed him if he makes speed. He only has Razor Shell. We should lift that. Okay, nice. So one Shell Smash one is out the way. Like these teams, they look bad, but you never know. I could get swept by this. Clawbit, so my. What was he going for? Aura Sphere. This thing has Dark Pulse. I mean, I have an AV Serena, so let's go to that. That did a shit ton. It might be Specs. Let me just U-turn here because the blade is pretty obvious. If he stays in, I can go to Klefki because I think that's Specs damage. Since I'm AV, that should be Specs. Oh, I'm just underestimating Clawbitzer. He goes to Snorlax. I don't get that play because I could be HJK. I feel like this just gives me a free Bishop knockoff. If he has Earthquake, yeah, I'm dead. Oh, actually, this is probably the pancake set. I regret this play a lot because he's the pancake set, yeah. Arnett won't kill. Fuck my life, dude. Flinch. No flinch, fuck. Yeah, I don't know why. I thought he was cursed. Without pancake, that was bad on me. I mean, offensive Nidoqueen is pretty nice, checks the blade and everything. I can just throw off an off power here. I mean, this life is more about having fun than about making the optimal plays. I don't feel like thinking hard at 3:30 a.m. I mean, I have to go to sleep soon, and he doesn't even have a sash. I just sex his claws guy. Yeah, this game is over, we win this. But I feel like I had to make a video to like say sorry to you, the ADF. And just in general, because I want to get daily content for you guys, and I might not be able to record tomorrow since I have to help in the office. I'll just Ice Beam this. Do some nice damage at these Citrus. Hyper Voice. I'll just Ice Beam again. Offensive Nidoqueen getting the kills. I mean, Kelly, Should love a hit from this thing. I just don't let it set up. But let me go to Serena anyway. Even though I don't want to stay in, because then the blood gets in SD if I stay in. But I have a Klefki with Fall Blade in the back. I still want a U-turn here. He shouldn't stay in, but he does. I don't get that why he's staying in for no reason. We'll just go to Keldeo as he gets the confusion. I'm a Hydro Pump here. Actually, I'm a Scald. Just for safe damage. Get a burn. Just bring that boy in range, and now we can go to Klefki and click Fall Blade on the Blade if he has these. Get up a spike for some chip on that Dublade. Okay, that's a shit ton, what the fuck? Why am I like fucking up really badly? I just go Serena. Middle King outspeeds this, yeah. And this is like max speed, which he shouldn't be. Now we off power twice and we win. But yeah. It was played really weirdly. How weird by me. I don't know how you said it in English correctly. Let's just not misclick here. So yeah, we don't let him set up. He said GG and we get another one for sure. It's only 70 minutes. I will get one or two more for you guys. Have fun, my man. He's like using Mega Aerodactyl probably, with Sun and Hail. That's interesting. I don't know what that accomplishes, because he doesn't have abusers for Sun or Hail. So it's either Rocks, Torkoal, Cordelli could be Curse, and we use that set in order to thing. Nape could be Scarf, could be Bandit, could be Sash. I mean, the Aerodactyl is pretty obvious as a lead, right? I feel like Nidoqueen does decently well versus most of his team, so I'm gonna lead that. As he leads Espeon, I will just go to my bishop. If he goes for HP fighting turn 1, I will just say he's a lord. We'll just call him a lord. I will just pursue this here. Yeah, as he tries to switch, gets pursued. Pretty nice to get rid of that Espeon. Torkoal is probably gonna go for Rocks here or Lava Plume or something. Let me think. This thing's actually annoying. But I feel like Nidoqueen is the play here. Yeah. As he will do the same that he just did, we will just get our rocks up too. He tries to get our Dectyl and potential off power. I will just Ice Beam this, I think. I think it's nice to have, but I don't have the best switch-ins for the Aerodactyl. I don't know why he overpredicted there. Maybe Stone Edge brings me in range for Earthquake. Yeah, it does rip. I mean, I can go to Scarf Ganga here. I can click Sludge Wave pretty freely, however you say that. Yeah, I'm gonna say some things again, like, because some people only watch my, like, some of my videos. This thing has bad speed F. But I need to keep this, so I'm just gonna kill you. So some things I want to talk about. Subscribe to my Twitch if you like want to see me stream. I start that when I hit 50 subs or 50 followers on Twitch. What else? If you have knowledge in older gens, then for DPP, Gen 5, Black and White, Black and White 2. So yeah, you can hit me up if you want to join videos. Somebody commented on one of my videos that he wanted to join a video or something, and he had like knowledge. So yeah, just hit me up again. My Discord is hashtag 5813, I think, Dockridge. That's my code, and my Skype is just Dockridge. So yeah, we'll just Hydro Pump here to kill this. Not sure if Scald kills, don't feel like calking. So he gets up the hail, and I was supposed to say is he Mega, but he's Mega Aerodactyl, and I don't even know if Mega Abomasnow is out. I feel like Klefki or Bishop is the player. Bishop and then Iron Heading seems like a good play. Klefki's nice with Toxic in case the Credility gets out of hand with Curse, unless it's like Rest Credility. Gets a crit, which is a bit annoying. Don't see what's wrong with Iron Heading here, just pick this off, yeah. Like, he didn't have good three chance. He just forfeited. I mean, I'm gonna get one more for sure. Because that was quick and we are only at not 20 minutes. Yeah, I might stop it after this one. I hope I can go positive and not get an L, because this is user IDF's team. I want to win with her team, because this video is all about saying sorry to her. Like, I don't care if I like mention it 5 times, because it's like important, so I'm gonna like repeat myself. Okay, this guy, she has like a scary team, kind of scary. He doesn't have a rain setup, which is weird, because he has this rain abuser here and this rain abuser here. So maybe he's a rain dance on this or this, I don't know. The guard, Heracross could be banned, which is really scary. This could be like life over specs. This is just annoying with wish pass. This could be rocks. Oh, let me think here. I feel like Klefki overall. Overall, Klefki doesn't lose much. Just a solid lead in general. And yeah, we can just get rocks, right? I don't know why I thought I had rocks on this. I mean, spikes. So yeah, SPL gonna start soon again. Like tomorrow, the matchups come out tomorrow. On Monday. Today it's already 3 a.m. for me. February 13th, as he gets up his raw. So yeah, I feel like this guy's a solid team. He has potential spin Kabutops. This has natural cure, so there's no point in... There's no point in toxicking this, I think. And if I switch, he got momentum anyway, because he has E-turn. This might be spin. I mean, I don't have good switch-ins, but Kelly could be a potential play here. I feel like Kelly is fine. Don't want to let the Cleffy take any damage. Yeah, he's a Rain and said if he's that Z Continental, not yeah, Continental Crush, that will hurt. But yeah, we'll just click Secret Sword here. So he tries to flinch me. Doesn't get it, thankfully. This guy's scum. I mean, Cleffy Selby walls me, but I figured he might like try to stay in because he already set up the Rain. Oh, when Hurricane is gonna blow me away. Klefki's let my only resist. Actually, I could go Bisharp and then Sucker Punch. I don't know if that's specs, but he confuses me, which sucks. I hope I can like break through and get this Toxic off. On the Heliolisk, please. That's why I didn't T-Wave. Okay, I hit myself, which sucks. Heliolisk is really annoying, but there's Serena's AV, so I could check it. Should check it. And, he doesn't have ghost type, the ghost type. High jump kicking is fine. Spinning is fine too, actually. Spinning is a decent play here. He crits me. Oh god. Confuses me. I hit myself and then he crits me. All the hex. I mean, this isn't doing much at this point, so I can just sack it off. The T-Bolt's actually. I could have high jump kicked. I don't know why he would T-Bolt ever. But yeah, I can go to Scarf Gar here. And click Sludge Wave. Okay, I'm gonna click Trick, Predict, and Vaporeon, but that's not worth. He just sacks the Heliolisk, and I can trick this later if need be. I'll just go Keldeo or Bisharp. No, I'm gonna just go Klefki, actually. It's not be the best play, because Klefki is nice for Neuvern. I'm gonna try to toxic this, yeah, nice. He probably has Heal anyway. He doesn't burn me. Oh yeah, I'm bad, I forgot that. This has Hydration. So yeah, I'm playing like dog shit, let me just go to Serena and quick drop kick. I don't know why this guy's staying in for no reason, but it's working. I could've just high jump kicked the Heliolisk earlier with the Serena. Nokov should kill this now, but this is an awkward position to be in because I made some weird plays. Second Klefki was probably not the play, but I'm still in a decent position. This is nice for the Celebi. Kill doesn't do this much unless it kind of checks Terra, but like Nidoqueen does that as well, so I'll just sack this. I don't know why you would Hurricane a Bisharp, but I really don't get that play. I'm just gonna do this on Ice Beam. I hope I live ahead. I should live ahead, right? I'm another Queen, I'm bulky. Don't confuse me, dude. I'm a B. Oh, dude, I would be so pissed if you confused me there. But yeah, not the best playing for my part this game. 25 minutes is like a good time to end it off. If he outspeeds me, he does. Like, at this health, I don't live a hit from Heracross, and if I outspeed, I get big damage, which I live amazing. So I will just pick him off here with Shiva's life up. Moxie Heracross can actually still sweep my ass. Nah, Scarf Gengar beats him at this range. Just attack to ensure that it doesn't get a substitute if he's dead set. And I win the game with Scarf Gengar. Just with Sludge Wave. Like, Sludge Wave is like neutral versus Heracross, right? Is it neutral? I mean, it should bring him in Sucker Punch range. Wait, that only did 60, but okay. He only has Mega Hunt, so it's fine. We said GG, and thank you guys for watching. This was a bit nice and you. We are 11:59, so we will just continue on this alt. Actually, why did I let on my main alt? I don't want that people like recognize me when I let out, because then they make tryhard plays and shit. But yeah, it's fine. Big shout out to use IDF test. I cannot say this often enough. And shout outs to Bear of the Best. I hope you still make Rex. He's really busy. What's your guys' opinion on the Doggy Suspect test? Let me know down below. And if you have cool UU teams, pass me some. Actually, yeah, some guy, I was talking to some guy on AIM's Discord, and he like passed AIM a team, and he said I could use it as well. I might use that next. I'm gonna use some Volcanion if it's still UU and some Primarina, but yeah. Please send me your teams on, and either my Smogon wall, my Smogon is Dockridge, or my Skype, or my Discord, and yeah, if you need any more information, just ask for it in the comments. And SPL coming soon, maybe like during the end of the week there's more SPL coming. Like, most people play their games at weekend. So yeah, I'm gonna upload that like over the next week, like after this week. I mean, I'm gonna upload a few SPL games this week, but after two, because it's impossible to upload every game like the same day, and no one will be able to watch it anyway. Too many games I want to. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. I made this longer at the end for the talking for no reason again. 27 minutes. Peace out, friends. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for the support. I think we had 400 subscribers. I think I was at 400 and I was at 399 when I looked a few minutes ago, so I lost one again. But yeah, if you like sub to me, you are the 400 subscribers. Shoutouts to you. Peace out, friends.